unfortunately, I kind of, you lose touch a little. You know, you kind of go in and out. You know, when I moved to my studio in Chelsea, I thought I would see more and kind of get back in touch with stuff, and the opposite happened. I go to my studio and I leave my studio and I don't see anything because I think, oh, I'll do it tomorrow. When I used to go there, I used to go just to look at stuff. I mean, again, I'd have to go back to, there are painters that I see whose names I can't even recall, but, you know, I'll leave this question off on a kind of a very big and very hard to define word, which there's work conceptually, there's work that I think as being very soulful, very filled with a lot of feeling. And that's the work I respond to the most. Who could I think of? I mean, it could be hard-edged, it could be, you know, there's so many different variations on that. But, I mean, you know, there are young painters. Someone like Dana Schutz is, to me, a really terrific painter. Someone like, what do I see? I mean, I just saw a Sugimoto show, which I thought was really beautiful. Cy Twombly's new paintings, as he gets older, his paintings get more magical. They in a way kind of begin to lose their anchorings. A lot of, you know, photographers that I see I like. Some of the German photographers, Jim Welling. I still like Barbara Kruger's work. I like work that's direct work. You know, I mean, it's the work that really delivers Richard Serra, the work that delivers the experience, you know, emotionally, perceptually, historically, and talks about this contemporary life.